roaring from the pit and the pounding of guns grew louder. My fear rose at the sound of someone creeping into the house.
Anyone here?
Come in. Here, drink this.
Thank you.
What's happened?
They wiped us out. Hundreds dead, maybe thousands.
The heat ray?
The Martians. They were inside the hoods of machines they'd made. Massive metal things on legs. Giant machines that walked. They attacked us. They wiped us out.
Machines?
Fighting machines. Setting fire to everything in sight. Just hunks of metal, but they knew exactly what they were doing.
We started out on foot. There didn't seem to be a living soul anywhere.
Is everybody dead?
Not everybody. Look, six cannons with gunners standing by.
Bows and arrows against the lightning. They haven't seen the heat ray yet.
Suddenly, there was a heavy explosion. The ground heaved, windows shattered, and gusts of smoke erupted into the air.
Look! There they are! What did I tell you?
Quickly, one after the other, four of the fighting machines appeared. Monstrous tripods, higher than the tallest steeple, striding over the pine trees and smashing them. Walking engines of glittering metal. Each carried a huge funnel, and I realized with horror that I'd seen this awful thing before. A fifth machine appeared on the far bank. In an instant, it raised itself to full height, flourished the funnel high in the air, and the ghostly, terrible heat ray struck the town. As it struck, all five fighting machines exulted, emitting deafening howls which roared like thunder. The six guns we had seen now fired simultaneously, decapitated the fighting machine. The Martian inside the hood was slain, splashed to the four winds, and the body, nothing now but an intricate device of metal, went whirling to destruction. As the other monsters advanced, people ran away blindly, but I jumped into the water. Until forced up to breathe. Now the gun spoke again, but this time the heat ray sent them to oblivion. With a white flash, the heat ray swept across the river. A huge wave near to boiling point rushed upon me, and I screamed aloud. Then scalded, half-blinded, and agonized, I staggered through leaping, hissing water towards the shore. I fell helplessly in full sight of the Martians, expecting nothing but death. The foot of a fighting machine came down close to my head, then lifted again as the four Martians carried away the debris of their fallen comrade. And I realized that by a miracle, I had escaped.